see example 11.2. If capital X is a random variable, here capital X is a continuous random variable with probability density function. They have given you the probability density function small f of x, okay, which is nothing but x minus 1 from the interval 1 to 2. Okay, the function is defined as x minus 1 within the interval 1 to 2, and again from 2 to 3 it is defined as minus x plus 3 and 0. Otherwise, apart from this interval, my function is defined as 0. Okay, and here you have to find the distribution function capital F of x. So you are going to find the distribution function here, and then the value of p of 1.5 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2.5. Okay, so for finding capital F of x, we have a formula. You all know that is f of x is nothing but p of x less than or equal to x, which is nothing but integral over minus infinity to x f of u du. So this is my definition for distribution function. Distribution function is otherwise called as cumulative distribution function. Okay, so here we are going to find the cumulative distribution function. See, my function is defined in three parts. So I am going to take it as an interval from minus infinity to plus infinity. Right? Here I am going to mark the interval. First is from 1, next is 2, next is 3. 1, 2, 3. So here I have 1, 2, 3, 4 intervals. Right? Here I have 4 intervals. That is, one is from minus infinity to 1. Another is from 1 to 2, next is 2 to 3, and 3 to infinity. So here, how I am going to find my cumulative distribution? You all know, to find the cumulative distribution function for random discrete random variable, that is, you will add all the probability mass function of previous random variables. If you have, for example, 0, 1, 2, then p of x is equal to x is here. If I have 1 by 4, this is 2 by 4. Again, this is going to be 1 by 4. The cumulative distribution of this is, wow, that is p of x is less than or equal to x. First, for 0, I'll take as such 1 by 4. For 1, I'll add this 0 again to this 1. So, I'll be getting 3 by 4. Again, for 2, I'll add all those 3 with this 2. Sorry, 2. So, I'll be getting 4 by 4. Always, the probability distribution value of this final random variable will be equal to 1. This is in case of what? Discrete random variable. Whereas, we are going to find the same thing for continuous random variables. Here, we are going to take, instead of a random variable, we are going to take an interval. So, my first interval is nothing but minus infinity, 1. And second interval is 1, 2. And third interval is 2, 3. And final interval is 3, infinity. So, first I am going to find the probability for first interval. For in case of second, I'll add the first interval to it. For the case of third, I'll add both first, second to the third. And for final, I have to add all those things with the final. Okay? So first, we'll find for the first interval. Okay? That is, I'm going to take my x which lies in minus infinity. So first, we are going to take the first interval. That is, when x is less than 1, it means x lies between minus infinity to 1. See, my random variable has been defined from minus x, sorry, x minus 1, that is from 1 to 2, minus x plus 3 is 2 to 3, and otherwise my random variable is equal to 0. And so, what my function is, f of x is equal to, that is minus infinity to 1, f of u du, which is nothing but 0. Okay? So first f of x is 0 because the function is not defined in the interval minus infinity to 1. Okay? And next is when x lies between the interval 1 to 2, that is 1 less than or equal to x less than 2. So the first interval, here my function is defined as x minus 1. So before going for that, what I have to do is f of x is equal to, what is my definition? Minus infinity to x Here, this is from 1. First, I'll take 1. F of u, du. Then, from 1 to 2. Instead of 2, my definition has x as a final value. So, I'll be taking x here. F of u, du. Right? So, this is nothing but 0. And there, f of x, f of u is defined as what? X minus, sorry, u minus 1 into du. Right? So my function is defined in u here, so that's why I have changed my variable x into u, right? Now I'm going to integrate this. Since it is on power 1, we can straight away integrate it as u minus 1 the whole square by 2 within the interval 1 to s. Okay? So first we are going to apply upper limit and then lower limit. So while applying upper limit, I'll be getting x, right? X minus 2, sorry, x minus 1 the whole square by 2 minus of, when I give the lower limit, it is nothing but 1. So if I give for u, I'll be getting 0. So this will become 0. And finally, f of x is equal to x minus 1 the whole square by 2. So this is my f of x when x lies between 1 to 2. And next is the third interval, that is when x lies between 2 to 3, right? So here my f of x is defined from the starting point, that is minus infinity to 1, f of u du plus 1 to 2, f of u du plus integral over 2 to, my final limit is x. And have to, in case of cumulative distribution, will not go for this value, will go for only the x which is given in the definition, okay? Since it is not closed, okay? Next is, the value of this is 0, you all know. And value of this is, we have to find, what is my definition? Sorry, random variable, it's nothing but what? U minus 1, right? Integral over 1 to 2, u minus 1. Into du plus of integral over 2 to x, it is defined as minus x plus 3. Sorry, here it is u minus u plus 3 into du. Right? Now I'm going to integrate this. This is nothing but u minus 1 the whole square by 2 from the interval 1 to 2. Next plus of here I'll be having the same. U plus 3 by 2. Here also we have the degree as 1. So we can take it as u minus u plus 3 the whole square by 2. Here I have minus u, so I will be getting a minus sign here from the interval 2 to x. Now I am just going to apply the upper limit and lower limit for this 2 intervals. Okay? So when I give the upper limit here, I will be getting 2 minus 1. Right? 2 minus 1 is nothing but 1. 1 square by 2 is again 1. When I give 1 here, 1 minus 1 will become 0. So for first, I will be getting 2 minus 1 is 1. 1 square is nothing but 1. So I will be getting 1 by 2 plus of here. When I go for upper limit, which is nothing but x here. So minus x plus 3 by 2, this is whole square. And I have a minus here. So, I can take that minus in common. Okay. So, next, I am going to apply my lower limit. My lower limit is 2. So, when I apply 2 there, I will be getting minus 2 plus 3 is nothing but 1. So, here, minus of 1 by 2. Okay. So, this is nothing but. So I will apply the limit again. See, first for this I am going to apply the upper limit, that is 2. When I give 2 here, 2 minus 1 is 1. 1 square is again 1. So I will be getting 1 by 2. Okay. Plus of minus. You have a minus here. I will take it as such. So minus of here I am going to give upper limit. My upper limit is x. So minus x plus 3 the whole square by 2. So I will be getting minus x plus 3 the whole square by 2 minus of, see, I'm going to apply my lower limit, that is minus 2 plus 3 by minus 2, right? So minus 2 plus 3 is nothing but 1 by 2. So I have a minus here, so that will become plus again. So I'll be getting 1 by 2. Okay? So next, what we are going to do is, we are just going to add it up. This is nothing but 1. See, 1 minus of x plus 2 the whole square by 2. And this can be written as, so this is my f of x. Okay? And next, what we are going to do is, we are going to find when x is greater than 3. That is, from 3 to infinity. And here, f of x is defined from minus infinity to 1. So first, this is my first interval. And next is from 1 to 2, which is my second interval. And next is from 2 to 3, f of u du. And plus finally, from 3 to x, f of u du. So here my function minus u was defined as 0 in the interval minus infinity to 1, and similarly above 3 my function is just not defined, that is 0 otherwise. So here we have only two intervals, one is 1 to 2 f of u du plus 2 to 3 f of u du, and we are going to consider only those two intervals, that is f of u is nothing but integral over minus 1 to 2, in this my function is defined as x minus 1, sorry, u minus 1 into du, plus again in 2 to 3, it is defined as minus u plus 3 into du. Now we are just going to integrate it. So here this will become u minus 1 the whole square by 2 from 1 to 2 plus of minus u plus 3 the whole square by minus 2 from 2 to 3. So first here I am going to apply the upper limit. When I give the upper limit, it will become 1. So 1 by 2. When I give the lower limit, it will become 0. So next, plus of, first if I give the upper limit, it will become 0. And when I give the lower limit, I will be getting what? Minus of. Here, and another, while applying lower limit, I will get 1 minus, so which is nothing but again 1 by 2, which is equal to 1. That is, capital F of x is equal to 1. Okay? So here, I have found the F of x for all the intervals, which is now minus 0, and minus infinity, less than x, less than 1. And next is, we have defined as x minus 1 the whole square by 2 from 1 less than x less than 2, and next is what? 1 minus of x plus 2 the whole square by 2. Okay? I'm sorry, I have made a mistake here. See, this is nothing but, 3 minus x the whole square by 2, right? See, it is nothing but 1 minus of 3 minus x the whole square by 2, okay? Which is nothing but an interval, 2 less than x less than 3. And when we go for 3, see, it is greater than 3. My function is 1, that is x is greater than 3. Okay, so this is my cumulative distribution function. Finally, we are going to define the cumulative distribution, the distribution function, the distribution function is capital F of x is equal to, see, my first limit is minus infinity less than x less than 1. Here my function is defined as 0. Okay? And next is 1, which is less than or equal to x, which is less than 2, which is the given interval. Here, my function has been defined as minus x, sorry, x minus 1 the whole square by 2. And next limit is 2 less than or equal to x, less than 3. Here, what we have found is 1 minus 3 minus x the whole square by 2. Okay? And finally, when x is greater than or equal to 3, and this can be also written as 3 less than or equal to x less than infinity. Okay? So which is nothing but 1. So finally, the cumulative distribution to the final interval is 1. Okay? Next, the second substitution, that is p of 2.5 less than or equal to x. Sorry. P of 1.5 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2.5. This is my second part. Okay? Here this can be found using the formula f of 2.5 minus f of 1.5. Okay? So this can be found using the formula f of 2.5, that is upper limit minus lower limit. Okay? See here, f of 2.5 lies where it lies here. See, 2.5 lies in this interval. So I can take the function 1 minus 3 minus x by 2 the whole square. Okay? So next from f of 1.5, see which it lies in the interval 1 to 2. For this I am going to consider this function. So we are going to take 1 minus of 3 minus x the whole square by 2. See, instead of x I have 2.5. So I will be taking 2.5 instead of x. Okay? So 2.5 the whole square by 2 minus of, and here for f of 1.5, I will be taking the function x minus 1 the whole square by 2, whereas my x is 1.5, so I will be substituting 1.5 instead of x the whole square by 2. Now I am just going to simplify this, and this is nothing but 1 minus of, see 0.5 the whole square, which is nothing but 0.25 divided by 2 minus of here. 1.5 minus 1 is nothing but 0.5. 0.5 the whole square is again nothing but 0.25 divided by 2. Okay? So this is nothing but minus of 0.5 by 2. So 1 minus of 0.5 by 2. Again, this is nothing but 0.25. So 1 minus 0.25 is nothing but 1 minus 0.25 is nothing but 0.25.